Accessie Bility from the Glasgow Messen. For my project, I am reading 50 Queers Who Changed the World by Dan Jones. Andy Warhol, 1928-1987, is the American artist who lorded over a court of legendary creatives, musicians, models, celebrities, drag queens and oddballs in 1960s, 70s and 80s New York City. His official legacy is an impossibly vast collection of films, video, drawings, screen prints and sculpture, interview magazine, The Velvet Underground, album covers, books, and hilariously sharp-tongued diaries. Then there are the wonderfully weird time capsules, approximately 600 boxed and filed letters, objects in ephemera, and 30 ghostly silver white wigs. But it's a near indefinable thing that marks Warhol out as a queer hero. His work was to underline others' sexual rather than his own, to swing the spotlight away from his shy Pennsylvanian persona and onto the drag stars, punk girls, leather boys and handsome hustles that hang out at the original silver factory. For those who document Warhol's own sexuality, one conclusion is usually reached. It's complicated. He balanced Ruthenian Catholicism with being an openly gay man, and shocked with films like Blowjob, 1964, and Tailor-Made's Bass, 1965. That implied a life of debauchery, even though he liked to watch from the sidelines and was usually in bed by 10 p.m. At a time when his fame was absolute, Warhol's work was unveiled and celebrated a queer underworld that was previously unknown. In 1968, Warhol survived a major attempt that left him with lifelong medical problems. The factory increased security, stalling the creative freedom the Warhol set had enjoyed for almost a decade. When he died in 1987, Warhol left behind artworks and artifacts that seemed to scream their queerness, but his own true wants remain hidden between the lines.